The flavor in my flow is infinite.
Yes.
I sink deep into the beats and use my voice as an instrument.
Indeed.
I sprinkle them in increments and let them know I'm sick with this. I get better, you get worse with time.
Isn't
it a travesty? And what you think is dope is really dirt to me. Certainly it's all opinion, but it doesn't work for
it don't
me.
Work.
Can't relate. It's not hate, I'm just not feeling it.
According to Adrian Broner, after these three fights, I can be done with boxing for good. My next fight is Radek. I'll be champion in my next two fights at 140 pounds. First, I want Regis Progay, of course. Get him out of the way, and then I'm going to knock them all off. I'm going to be undisputed before I'm done with this. Utter nonsense.
Ended up a casualty. Passports can stand. We pass borderlines. You dudes borderline whack. We don't work with your kind.
Interesting matchup between Avril Mathy, who is something of a Australian Instagram model slash boxer, and Amlat Ali of 258 Promotions slash Natural. That's going to be interesting because the personalities couldn't be more different. Personally, I don't back the Somali fighter, but I'm not too fond of Avril Mathy either, forgive me. She does tend to walk around with a bikini a lot, but she does dedicate herself to honing their skills, so it should be interesting to see how that plays out. It must be extremely difficult for Leonard Ellerby at the moment, especially. Leonard Ellerby really depended a lot on Gervonta Davis in regards to his profile. In fact, so much so that his presence on social media, particularly Twitter, has reduced exponentially, significantly. We hardly hear anything from Leonard Ellerby since Gervonta Davis parted ways with Mayweather Promotions. Before, he was all over the place, wasn't he? He had a comment for everything, particularly everything Eddie Hearn. Now I think he's traumatized. I think he feels humiliated. I feel he feels embarrassed. I think he knows, okay, that in as much as the war of words is concerned regarding Eddie Hearn, regardless of what you think of Eddie Hearn was correct and he won. I mean, we realize that Mayweather's being rather philosophical about it, as he usually does. You could decipher it to mean something else when he says, like, you know, good luck to him if he wants to surpass me, and so on and so forth. You get this feeling that when Mayweather says things like that, that in the back of his mind he's thinking, like, I hope that doesn't happen. I'm going to make sure within everything, do everything within my power to ensure that that doesn't happen. But I mean, he can't stop the rain. But he probably feels that Gervonta Davis can't do what he did without him, because the blueprint for doing things like that does belong to him. And I don't think that Gervonta Davis is mentally strong enough to cope with the amount of pressure that comes with not doing certain things that fans demand of him. I think at the moment he's nice and comfortable. But when that Brian Garcia situation starts getting closer, and Gervonta Davis does what he does, which is more or less to try and renege and try and find a way out and do something else that's going to make him more money rather than taking this high profile fight that's just going to stress him out mentally. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm not saying he can't win it or he won't win it. I'm saying that he doesn't like the mental pressure of it. I think it's better when you have a sure thing and you feel that you can go into a fight and you can get easy money. You know what I'm saying? In a fight where your fans are celebrating you rather than the fans being divided and the pressure that comes with that. Because make no mistake, when Gervonta Davis goes into a fight against Ryan Garcia, the fans are going to be somewhat divided. There's going to be, of course, a whole bunch of black nut huggers who are going to jump on Ryan Garcia's dick as well, because that's just what they do. You know what I mean? Based upon this supposed perception of Ryan Garcia having this, what Rolly Romero described as a left hook from hell. But that's by the by. I don't think Gervonta Davis can cope with that type of mental pressure. And neither can Ryan Garcia, as a matter of fact. If it gets too hot, Ryan Garcia himself might pull out. So I don't think that fight's going to happen. But going back to Leonard Ellerby himself, I think he must be traumatized, because he's really going to have to deal with the fact that in the aftermath of everything, Eddie Hearn won, and Leonard Ellerby is nowhere to be found. He's at the moment persona non grata because Gervonta Davis is having this fight, and you know, what can he say? What can he do? He's in hiding right now. Even though all over social media, you're not going to find Leonard Ellerby there. I won't be surprised if he hasn't actually terminated. Well, let's not get carried away. I don't think he's terminated his account. I think if something happens that embarrasses Eddie Hearn a little bit, he's going to like it, of course, because that's just the insecurity that eats away at the man. But let's keep it real, it doesn't get any better than Gervonta Davis. I think he worked, as far as he's concerned, he would believe that he worked tirelessly on behalf of Gervonta Davis, constantly heaping praise upon him as being a star and so on and so forth. And this is the end result of it. This is the reality of it. That regardless, you were not indispensable. And Gervonta Davis decided to get rid of you, parted ways, and now you're back. You're back to not back where you started, but you know, you're back to your rightful position as being a I don't know what is Leonard Lippy anyway. But moving on, let's talk about Gervonta Davis. Let's talk about boxing in general. So here we are again, the year 2023. We're trying to get excited about fights that might happen. Fights that have been rumored about, that the fighters themselves claim they're looking forward to and want to see get done. There's more rumors than actual action itself, more gossip, same old stuff. But anyway, speaking strictly about boxing, Gervonta Davis is about to go into a fight against this guy called Hector Luis Garcia, also known as the Android or something, or the Android in Spanish. I don't know how they say it, but I'm gonna tell you what, man. Regardless of how I often despise how Hispanics celebrate after they get the win over a black fighter, I'm somehow hoping that there is some sort of surprise there. I'm not sure whether I want to upset, but part of me does want an upset. Part of me does want Gervonta Davis to lose. However, I'm aware of the fact that should he lose, a lot of racism is going to come spilling out, and not just from white fans, but from the Hispanic fans as well. They're going to go crazy. And I'm not just talking about the boxers themselves or the Hispanic trainers, and I'm talking about the commentators, you know, the ones who pretend to be within the middle of conversations, except when it comes to things like Tank Davis and PBC. Then you see the sort of nastiness come out of them. That's always latent. That's always dormant. And just needs a little prod and a little prick to come out, particularly when it comes to Gervonta Davis. So, but Gervonta Davis himself, for me, I find him unlikable. I don't like Gervonta Davis as a person. I think I admire his boxing, but you know what? It's gotten to a point where I'm beginning to forget what his boxing is really about, you know what I'm saying? I just see this little short, arrogant, well, I don't even mind him being arrogant, but this little short, ignorant, almost mediocre fighter at the moment, at this point in time, at this juncture. He's been called out based upon his connection with another guy, and I gotta be honest, yeah, without the backing of Floyd Mayweather, I think he's lost some of that attraction, some of that luster, some of that appeal. The only person who's got this, who's still moist somehow for Gervonta Davis, is Ryan Garcia. And I think there's something else there. I think it's a case of who I want to prove I'm the prettiest rather than I'm the best boxer when it comes to Ryan Garcia, to keep it real with you. I think it's not so much about the boxing itself, but I think his obsession with Gervonta Davis has got to do with the fact that he feels he's prettier or some shit like that. And that's another thing. I'm hoping that something happens to upset the procedure and process of Ryan Garcia thinking that all he needs to do is fight Tank Davis. And even that, if Tank Davis wins, which is most likely, more than likely, okay, but not guaranteed, because this is boxing at the end of the day. Even if he wins, right, I hope that something happens to spoil that party. I really don't give a fuck what happens with boxing nowadays. You know, I'm going to keep it real with you. I really don't care. Because if people care that much about boxing, I don't even want to be fucking with people like that. There's just too much going on in the world. And since I haven't been making videos, I've sort of doubled my the amount of time I dedicate to other things that are more fulfilling doing that. Why was I wasting time on nonsense? You know what I'm saying? I mean, it might not seem like a lot, but it's a lot. So for me, it is what it is. I can't be making boxing videos. I don't even watch boxing videos to the extent that I did, because it's the same old narrative being regurgitated. I'm watching some people that I like, you know what I'm saying? But even then, you know, it's the same old criticism and critique of certain things that are not happening, that should happen, the records and so on and so forth. And it's just, that whole thing is stale. The whole approach is stale. And that also goes for boxing debates. I think boxing debates are dead. I really do feel that boxing debates are very subpar compared to the kind of debates that people are having in basketball. But honestly, I think boxing has sort of enjoyed a lot of hype. I think boxing has benefited from this base instinct that men or humans need to fight rather than the sport itself. So a lot of myth and legend has been created out of bullshit. Because let's keep it real, people lie. Let's keep it real, people lie. They lie about everything. Just, you know. And I'm not saying that to say that everything's a conspiracy or, you know, how people get down or other things, particularly when it comes to the pandemic and so on and so forth. I'm saying that people just lie. But that's just a little thing. But, you know, in order to get things done, they're going to lie. It is what it is. So if we talk about those little things there, what makes you think when it comes to boxing? You know, we were talking about, let me give you an example, right? Jack Johnson, who we all like to celebrate. There are things about Jack Johnson that really, in all honesty, I'm not comfortable with. Particularly when people get all excited and talk about grooming and all this type of stuff. If we're talking the absolute truth about Jack Johnson, rather than the nice convenient lie of the sin of blackness, whatever the fuck they call it, I don't think he, in this day and age, he would be appreciated to the extent that they appreciate him. You know what I'm saying? I don't think, because he was on the Andrew Tate shit. Let's keep it a buck. But that being said, right? That being said, Gervonta, what do I predict for this fight? I don't know. I really don't know. Honestly, it's weird not to see Leonard Ellerby's nose flaring and giving this fake, over-exaggerated smile behind Gervonta Davis or in the middle of the two fighters. It's strange not to see Floyd Mayweather trying to take advantage of it and raise his profile on the back of that again. I mean, his profile is raised, but, you know, try to remain current and frequent. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that was a massive failure on behalf of Floyd. You could say Floyd helped Gervonta Davis to the extent that he had, and I do believe that he was instrumental in making Gervonta Davis as big as he is. But I would say that when you look at what Mayweather Promotions is bringing out right now, it is absolutely beyond and below mediocre. Those fighters will get no traction whatsoever. So in many ways, it's very hard to argue that Mayweather Promotions actually made Gervonta Davis, even though Mayweather himself was instrumental in making Gervonta Davis. The promotional company itself has failed on so many levels in regards to other fighters. The first indication of that, of course, was when Richardson Hitchens left. And now we don't even know anybody else on that platform, or if anything, apart from Rolly Romero. And we're not even sure whether Rolly Romero is still a Mayweather Promotions fighter, considering that nobody was really interested in fighting Rolly Romero. And Rolly Romero is going to turn out to be... There's a guy in England by the name of Tyan Booth. I think that's the path that Rolly Romero is on. He's going to end up being something of an American, Hispanic Cuban type of Tyan Booth, who trolls through boxing on social media, and that's about it. Tyan Booth, if I'm not mistaken, used to be a boxer as well. I'd love to say. I couldn't watch him, but you know, there's an audience out there for that type of thing. And I suppose there's going to be an audience out there for Rolly Romero's nonsense as well. Deal, murderers to kill, any demon and ill, jump in my rocket to the moon, spark a L and just chill. I gotta own stocks and bonds, kid, just because I want them. $1 million businesses with dark man written on them. Not a front, but an economical stunt. I want it all, I hope I didn't put that too blunt. Educate, moving on up, like the Jeffersons. Cop a Lex, a Jag, a Land Cruiser, and a Benz. And a mossy of friends to dispose my foes. Stand over my shoulder while I had crack and CeeLo. Taking care of my peeps, cause I know how it be. Mad court cases and white papers, that's all we see. From the role of poverty, but I always got mine. Smuggled from now wide to MI on the main line. Now I'm in Cashville, still pursuing my path. Sever the mic in half to unleash my wrath. I want an abundance of girls to escape the world. Throw a party on solo, me and 17 pearls. Puffing on mad lockdown without a regard. I need 33 acres of ganja growing in my backyard. Four courts in the front and bathrooms big as kitchens. 1,000-gallon aquarium to sit my sharks in. All I want to stay, my whole crew living great. Enter the gate unannounced and you will meet your fate. I'm on Carlito's way, living life for real. Protected to infinity in a security shield. I want it all, Lex and Tex and shit. I want it all, flyways and
crazy